Hey guys, TommyBryson here, and today I'm gonna tell you exactly why I'm not going to buy a Tesla Model X and why I'm actually gonna go ahead and buy a Toyota Corolla between the year of 2017 to 2019, okay? I'm gonna give you guys all of the details. And by the way, if you've been here for a while, you've seen, for example, my car list change over the years. It used to be a Porsche, a Cayenne Porche, then it went from that to being a Tesla Model X, then it went from that to being a Lamborghini Urus, and then it went from a Lamborghini Urus all the way down to a Toyota Corolla. And you might say, for example, Tommy, that is a massive downgrade, but in reality, it's a $2 million investment potential if I just go ahead and buy that Toyota Corolla instead of going ahead and actually buy a Tesla Model X or a Lambo or a Porsche. And by the way, every time I say Toyota, I think about Yoda and Baby Yoda and Disney Plus and all that stuff. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? It's Star Wars, right? Everybody knows about that stuff. But overall, guys, okay, if you guys are new here, I post videos every single day on finance and money topics. Make sure to also go ahead and subscribe to the channel and hit the bell so you're notified. And on top of that, also destroying the like button. Now, the very first thing, guys, is all about price and also my initial plan. Ever since I was around 17 to around 18 years old, whenever I wanted something, I would print it out and then put it on my wall. So for example, when I wanted a car, I would go home, get the PDF of the whole car, customized and all that, and then go to school and use their paper and their ink to print out the whole details and grab that and put it on my wall. And every day I would look at it, okay? But by the way, thankfully, all my ideas from back then, I no longer use them, because usually those ideas did not have a good foundation. So in reality, okay, here's the first car I actually wanted to get. It was actually a Cayenne Porche, and it was around year 2017, okay? And in reality, that car today costs around $37,250. And I wanted it because basically, my uncle had a BMW X5, and I wanted something similar, but not the same. And I said to myself, wow, this car is so beautiful. When I saw it in person, I was like, okay, that right there is going to be my car. And by the way, when I customized it, it was actually over $100K. But today, you know, that car is worth a lot less money, and I can buy it right now for around $37,250. And then I fell in love with the Tesla Model X. I like the tech behind the car. I like how it can drive me around, and I don't need to drive it with the autopilot feature. And I also like the entire doors and how they opened up like that. Okay, that to me was so cool. And you might say, Tommy, for example, it sounds like you never liked Tesla in your video, but in reality, it's not like I don't like Tesla. The products are great, but it's just that, for example, I'm not going to buy something just because I like the product. For example, I like having a Nintendo Switch. I like this product a lot, but you don't see me buying Nintendo stock for around a PE ratio around 55. It's too expensive, okay? So that's why you don't see me basically buying Tesla. And it's not just because of PE ratio. The company overall is very expensive, and I am not interested in that game. However, the product, the actual product, is actually pretty cool. And by the way, if I bought a Tesla Model X today, year 2017 or so, I can get it for around $57,500, okay? That is the price right now for that Tesla. Now, on top of that, after that, I fell in love with basically quality of product, okay? And materials and all that stuff. I started to get very, very fancy, and that's when I fell in love with the Lamborghini Urus. And by the way, I saw a Lambo before I actually came out at a car show. The only car show I've ever been to in my whole life, and I saw that car right there. And I fell in love with it faster than I fell in love with my girlfriend. Just don't tell her that, okay? Because basically, well, yeah, she won't know. She doesn't watch these videos. But the answer is, yeah, I love that car so much. But it doesn't fit my rule of basically buying a used car that's at least between 3 to 5 years old. Because basically, that car is still at around 2019 and also 2020. And I'm never going to buy a car that's that brand new, because basically, you haven't had it depreciate at least a little bit more to actually give you a massive discount. Now, overall, guys, okay, that is my list of all the cars I wanted. And then I landed in this year, I'm actually going to buy this car, a Toyota Corolla for around $13,000. It's going to be either a model 2017 or, for example, a 2019 or so, okay, for $13K. That is my budget right there. And you might say, for example, Tommy, wow, so you went from Cayenne Porche to Tesla Model X to Lamborghini Urus all the way down to a Toyota Corolla between 2017 to 2019. Well, here is what we need to talk about. And it's basically investing over buying a nice car. But the answer is, I noticed that basically every time I switched cars was for a reason. The Porsche was great, but then the Tesla had technology. I liked it. The Lamborghini had basically quality. And now the Corolla, I changed it for a different reason. And the answer is basically, guys, when I think about buying this Corolla, I think about basically my family, my kids, my shareholders in the future, and also my investment potential. So here are all the details to why I'm actually going to go ahead and buy a Toyota Corolla when it comes to investment potential over buying one of those cars I told you guys about. Now, the answer is this, guys, okay? I'm going to show you guys right here all the math and all the numbers, okay? In reality, this right here is a compound interest calculator. And like I told you guys before, okay, if I bought a Porsche, a Cayenne Porsche 2017 for around $37,250, okay? If I deduct the price of a Toyota, which is 13K, in reality, I would have left over $24,250 to go ahead and invest. Now, how much money would that actually result in and actually give me? Now, again, that Toyota Corolla, I'm going to have that car, honestly, here for the next between 5 to 10 years. Most likely, 10 years of using that car over and over again. I think it's a great car. It's going to be just fine. The parts are easy to replace. The maintenance is not that hard either. So around 10 years, I'm going to be with that Toyota Corolla, okay? A minimum of 5 years if things go really, really good. But reality, most likely, is going to be 10 years. Now, if I were to invest the difference, okay, $24,250, okay? And I invested that money over a period of 10 years, guys, okay? Basically, the life of my Toyota, in reality, at a 10% return, because basically, I also reinvest my dividends. In reality, in 10 years, I would have around $62,000, okay? Enough money to buy me basically a brand new Porsche if I actually wanted to, or a very, very nice car. In reality, it's going to be a better deal. Now, if I left that money there, for example, for 40 years, in 40 years, I would have around $1 million. On top of that, my Tesla Model X, it would cost me around $57,500 minus the cost of my Toyota 13K. If I invested the leftover money, which is around $44,500, in reality, how much money do you think I would actually have? $45,500 over 10 years, I would actually have somewhere around $118,000, okay? If I just invested that money instead of going ahead and buying that Tesla, okay? Now, on top of that, in 40 years, that money would actually turn into around $2 million. Now, obviously, the biggest expense would probably be if I grabbed that money and bought basically a Lamborghini Urus. Now, right now, Lambo goes for around $220,000, okay? Now, if I subtract the cost of my Toyota, only 13K, I would be left over with around $207,000. Now, if I invested $207,000 and left that money there, for example, for 10 years, just invested, in reality, I would have around $536,000. Enough for me to actually go ahead, guys, okay? Here's the crazy math here. If I have $536,000, I could actually go ahead and buy, for example, around 41 Toyota Corollas, okay? That's how crazy this actually is. So in reality, it makes a lot of sense just to go ahead and buy my Toyota Corolla. Now, by the way, if I actually left that money there for around 40 years, guys, in reality, that Lambo would actually be worth around $9.3 million in the future if I just left that $207K there sitting and invested for the next 40 years or so. That's how crazy this actually is. So that's when I did that math, guys, okay, it turned my entire perspective upside down. If I'm investing so much money, why would I go ahead, put all that money towards a car? Basically, it drives me, but I'm just going to the gym. So it makes no sense, right? Because why do I need somebody to drive me to the gym? It makes no sense. My Porsche, great. Nice car, it's too expensive, the Porsche is too expensive. Also, my Lambo, if something breaks on that car, imagine how much money is going to cost me. On top of that, it's so much money to the point where it makes no sense for me to actually do it. So that's why I decided, hey, a Toyota Corolla has everything I want, which is basically Apple CarPlay. And that is all I basically want. Now, you're probably wondering by this point, Tommy, if you're investing your money, what exactly are you investing your money actually into? Okay, and by the way, guys, all those cars, gratefully and thankfully, today, if I wanted to, I could buy those cars for cash today, okay? The Lamborghini, or for example, the Tesla, or all those cars right there. But in reality, it makes no sense. In 10 years, a Lambo will be worth, for example, 50% less or so, okay? I can just go ahead and buy it then and ride it around just like that, okay? I don't need to buy that car today. And most likely, I'll never buy that car, if I'm being honest with you, okay? I'll probably buy a nice car, maybe, I don't know. But most likely, I don't know, guys, okay? I'm very cheap. I'm being honest here, I'm just very cheap, and I don't know if I'll ever spend that much money on a luxury car. I would have to have a ton of money already invested. But in my case, okay guys, tell me, if you're investing your money, what exactly are you going ahead and investing your money into? Well, in reality guys, I'm gonna show you guys right now. In reality, the app I use to invest is basically M1 Finance, okay? And by the way, guys, this right here is my phone. As you guys can see, it's my real phone. It's not a fake image. It's my real phone right here, okay? Now, the app I use to invest is called M1 Finance, okay? And this right here is the app. Let me scan my face. Boom, you guys see right here. And right now, so far, I've invested over $121,000 into the market. My portfolio is this right here, just a bunch of ETFs. By the way, if you want to copy my portfolio, I have a link down below to my portfolio and also a link down below to other portfolios. That way, if you want to be more risky, I have one for that. Less risky, more conservative, I have one for that also. This way you have more options. But in reality, this is what I basically invest my money into. And by the way, guys, okay, by the end of this year, if everything goes okay, I'll probably have, for example, $450K actually invested. That's how cool this actually is. So if I have, for example, $450,000 invested, or for example, I bought a Lambo or a Tesla, all those things absolutely make no sense, right? But in reality, if I went ahead and I invested that much money, right? And by the end of the year, I have $450,000. If I go ahead and I follow my rule of the 4% rule, okay? Basically meaning I will never take more than 4% of my portfolio. So if I have a portfolio of $450,000, and I take every single year just 4% of that, okay, guys, that's $18,000 every single year. Now, again, this year, I'm moving to Fort Myers, okay, meaning that with $18,000 a year divided by 12, guys, okay, it means that I get around $1,500 being paid to me passively from my portfolio, meaning, for example, that covers my rent, my insurance, my gas, my gym, my food. It covers everything absolutely. So in reality, you tell me, Tommy, do you prefer to go ahead and get, for example, a Lamborghini Urus or a Porsche or a Tesla, or do you prefer to actually get, for example, free rent for a minimum of 33 years? The answer is obviously, I'd rather get the free rent, keep investing more and more money in the future, potentially just keep growing my money. And eventually, if I want to buy a Lambo, I can buy a 5-year-old model for a massive discount. But again, you know, that car brings a lot of attention and I don't really like attention. So in reality, I might not buy that at all. Or I just might buy, for example, a Tesla. But in 10 years, Teslas will probably be a lot more cheaper. And on top of that, there'll probably be a lot more options out there when it comes to electric cars that actually have cool technology. Because by the way, Tesla is going to have a ton of competition, which most likely will actually make prices actually go lower and lower and lower. But overall, guys, okay, whenever it comes to buying a nice car or buying a nice this or that, in reality, most likely it's going to be a better deal to just go ahead and invest that money and eventually have that money buy you the car you actually want to buy. So that's basically why I'm going to go ahead and buy a Toyota Corolla for $13,000. And by the way, if I wanted to, I can buy a $5,000 or $4,000 model, but in reality, I want a good car that's going to last me a minimum of 10 years, okay? That is basically what I want. But Tommy, are you really going to drive that car for 10 years? In reality, Warren Buffett drove a Cadillac, not even a nice one, for 10 years. If you can do that, I can drive my Toyota Corolla for 10 years. And by the way, guys, in the future, when I keep investing all this money and so on and so on, I'll create partnerships and then eventually make a public company so then you guys can go ahead and invest money into it. That's my plan also. So Lamborghini or that plan? That plan, obviously, okay? That's the whole idea. And by the way, it'll get to a point where basically, I can basically grab all my money and buy maybe 1,000 Lamborghinis, okay? That's the whole goal there. To the point where it doesn't bother me to actually go ahead and buy that car, but I never want to buy something that's a liability that's going to hurt me right now currently to then just go ahead and ride around looking fancy, okay? It's just not a good idea. But overall, guys, thanks for watching this video. Comment down below. Let me know, do you agree with me or do you not agree with me? And by the way, comment down below also, what is a good car, like Toyota Corolla, a good car is going to last me a long time that you guys also recommend? And also comment down below exactly what was or what is going to be your first car. Comment down below. Let me know. And by the way, be realistic. Don't say, I want this Tesla or I want this whole thing here. If you do say that, in reality, I failed at this video. The point is, buying a fancy car is not a good deal when you're getting started, okay? That's the whole goal of this video. Now, see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching. As always, like if you liked it. On top of that, also, if you're new here, subscribe to the bell so you're notified. If you want to text me or talk to me one-on-one, join my Patreon link down below or send me a DM on Instagram at TommyBryson. And before I go, if you want to see exactly how to buy a car and get it for free, luxury cars, here's that video right here. I click my face right now. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching. And as always, peace.